Hi everybody. Hopefully this is the first in a series of videos I'm planning to do about the chromatic harmonica. What is a chromatic harmonica? What am I trying to do? Basically, I'm trying to get more people interested in trying to play the chromatic harmonica. I'm quite enthusiastic about it myself. I love the instrument. And I try to get more people interested in trying to play and learn how to play the chromatic harmonica. First of all, in this first video, I'm trying to discuss what difference or what is actually a chromatic harmonica and maybe go into the reason why I think you should buy one and try and play it. Most people, when you talk about the word harmonica, most people have got this idea about this type of harmonica. It's a very small, tiny little harmonica with 10 holes at the front, no frills, very basic. They used to be quite cheap, not anymore. But this is a diatonic harmonica. Now, most people, when I've mentioned the word harmonica, think of this type of harmonica. It's quite small. It easily fits in your hands. Only got 10 holes, and it's called a diatonic harmonica. Most people, again, with a harmonica, this is what people think of. The diatonic harmonica is quite a nifty little instrument, but it comes with a few problems. It sounds quite nice, but again, I don't need to play you this because there's loads and loads of videos about people playing the diatonic harmonica on YouTube. But just to give you an idea, you can play this. Kind of what it sounds like, not perfect. Again, there's a lot of people out there that play this little harmonica a lot better than I can. But it's got a few problems, as I said. What is the first one? The harmonica, this one, spans a range of 3 octaves. So basically, it's from do to do 3 times, 3 octaves. So if you look, one octave, 2 octaves, third octave. So it spans a range of 3 octaves. Now, if you look on a keyboard and you find a range of 3 octaves on your keyboard and you count all the keys that are in 3 octaves, you come to a total of 37 keys. On the harmonica, there's only 10 holes there, and every hole can only have 2 reeds. One to blow air into, so one reed will sound when you blow, and another reed will sound in the same hole when you breathe in through the harmonica. So for instance, if I blow it in the first 3 holes at the same time, and if I then draw air, so I breathe in, there's different notes. So that's how it works. So there's only 2 reeds in every hole, which means the whole harmonica has only got 20 reeds. 37 notes, only 20 reeds. So you can tell straight away that in this there's a lot of notes are missing, that are just not there. To me, personally, and don't get me wrong, I don't want to say anything wrong about this diatonic harmonica, but the missing notes are frustrating me like anything. Now, there are people that can play the missing notes in between, but that takes a lot of practice. It takes breath control, breath technique, etc., to get all the notes in between, bending, overblows, and etc., etc. It takes a hell of a lot of time to master that, and it also sounds quite different. Whereas, on the other hand, on the chromatic harmonica, all your notes in the 3 octaves that we're talking about, this range, all the notes are just there. on your key, all the notes, the same notes that are on your keyboard, are also on the chromatic harmonica. Which brings us to the chromatica. Now, there's different models, so don't take any notice of this model as such. But you can see, first of all, that the chromatic harmonica is a hell of a lot bigger than the diatonic. Why? Because instead of two reeds for each hole, the chromatic harmonica has actually got four reeds in each hole. Four reeds. Why? Because this has got all the notes that are missing on the other harmonica are actually here. So, from a learner perspective, if you're new to playing an instrument, the chromatic harmonica, in my opinion, is easier to learn than the diatonic harmonica. And what happens in the chromatic harmonica, like I said, every hole has got four reeds instead of two. And I just said about this, that you can only have two reeds. If you put any more reeds in this harmonica, you'd mess things up and you'd hear more tone notes at the same time. So, and there's the trick about the chromatic harmonica. If you look inside the holes of a chromatic harmonica, you will see that kind of half the hole is blocked. You can see only part of the hole being open and part of the hole is closed. And on the side of the harmonica, there's a button. There are more models, but this is just a button chromatic. So what happens if you push the button? You block the holes that are normally visible and you open the other half of the hole to get to the other two reeds. Have a look. Boom. So basically, it's two harmonicas in one. One is open, the other one is hidden. And with this slider, or the slider button, you choose between the two harmonicas within this chromatic. So that's how the main difference. So all your notes on the piano in those 33 octaves, 37 keys, are all in the same range of three octaves on this chromatic harmonica. That's why it has to be bigger as well. Still, however, I think the chromatic harmonica is quite a small instrument compared to a flute, a clarinet, or any other wind instrument you can think of. So why should you buy one? Now, first of all, because, like I said, it's relatively small. I wouldn't say it's pocket size, but definitely say handbag size. You can take it everywhere with you. It plays by itself. It doesn't need plugging in. It's not electronic. It's acoustic, so it just sounds just by your breath. Also, chromatic harmonicas are relatively cheap. You don't have to spend an absolute fortune, like, for instance, a clarinet, an oboe, a flute will set you back at least £1,000, if not many thousands of pounds, to get a good sounding professional instrument. Chromatic harmonicas are a lot cheaper. You can get yourself a very decent chromatic harmonica for less than £200. And there are a few professional models out there, really suitable for performance and etc., that you can get for around £700, which of course is a hell of a lot cheaper than any other instruments. So, the chromatic harmonica is small, relatively cheap to buy. Is it easy to learn? No, not really. But like I said, that's the same with every instrument. If you take it seriously and you want to really start playing, then you need to learn a lot. You need to do a bit of studying, to study how this instrument actually works. But still, with a bit of lessons, and this is what I'm trying to do in this series of videos, trying to get you to into maybe hopefully buying a chromatic harmonica and starting to play. Or maybe there's lots of you that have got a harmonica somewhere hidden in a sock drawer somewhere, haven't used it for years or anything. It's there somewhere, but you're not quite sure what to do with it or how to use it. So to those people, I would say get your harmonica out and start playing it, the chromatic harmonica. Now, first of all, I don't want to say anything bad about the diatonic harmonica. There is a lot of people harmonica players playing this little tiny instrument, and it sounds absolutely fantastic in the right hands and etc. with the right people. Now, I am not a diatonic harmonica player. I don't like these harmonicas, but that doesn't mean that they're bad in any way. So I don't mean to say anything bad about these. It's just not my cup of tea, and it frustrates all the notes that are missing on this. It's just frustrating me to no end. So the chromatic harmonica has got all the notes on the harmonica that you need, all the notes that appear in a chromatic scale on a piano, keyboard, flute, etc., etc. So all the notes are there. So why not pick up a chromatic harmonica, buy one, or hopefully you've got one somewhere still, maybe an inheritance from your granddad or something like that, and start playing it. The chromatic harmonica. Now, hopefully, this is just the first to actually explain what a chromatic harmonica is. In the next video, we will start exploring this chromatic harmonica. How does it sound? How do you make a sound? How do you play it? Etc., etc. So thanks for watching, and hopefully get yourself a chromatic harmonica and come back for the next video and see if this is something for you to try out. Thanks very much.